Hours after the shark attack in Lanikai, officials responded to reports of another attack, this time in Waikiki. At first, it was reported as a possible shark attack, but the doctor who treated the victim did not think so. So state officials reached out to an expert in Florida. He thinks the bite was more likely from an eel. We wanted to know how experts can tell what caused a bite just by looking at the wound. Bridget Numata spoke to that expert and got some answers. Bridget?
Thanks, Joe. The Waikiki surfer gave permission for DLNR to send photos of his foot to researchers at the University of Florida. A researcher says he's done over 6,000 shark attack investigations, and the photo he saw of the wound looked more like the bite of a moray eel. This is important because eel bites must be handled differently than shark bites. An eel bite is more irregular than a shark bite. They have very sharp, backward curving teeth that can slice and puncture human flesh. I'm told there are two types of moray eels found in Hawaiian waters that might have bit the surfer: a yellow margin, which can grow up to 5 feet long, or a giant moray eel, which can reach up to 8 feet. University of Florida shark expert George Burgess tells me a moray eel bite can be very tricky to treat.
The biggest problem with moray eel bites is not so much the direct damage, although they can make a ragged mess of lacerations, but the main problem is infections, and their teeth are loaded with various bacteria that are oftentimes very difficult to shut down with antibiotics.
Most eels are not highly aggressive. They usually stay away from humans and typically feast on fish or shellfish, but moray eels will defend their shelter. So experts say humans should not step on reefs or reach into any of the holes. Now, DLNR tells me it is still trying to confirm what bit the surfer. So for now, its investigation continues, and the state does not keep records of eel bites as it does for sharks. Bridget Numata, KH12 News.